I never really liked school very much growing up, but I always loved learning. I loved to read and learning about things. I just didn't really enjoy school all that much. And I think I was one of those kids that needed somebody to reach out and have a connection with a teacher. And that's what I realized, I guess, was that I have an opportunity to reach out to kids who otherwise wouldn't enjoy reading or wouldn't enjoy coming to school or don't realize their full potential.
For James, what it is that he builds those relationships that are so important. He has great classroom management. He cares about supporting every child every day. And I think that that's so important that he has that in mind every single day when he's teaching in the classroom. And you can see it.
One student I had for language arts, I signed up to kind of develop a relationship with his mother. And I said, hey, you know, your son's failing all of these core classes. We'd like to figure out if we can develop some strategies that you can support us at home. And she basically said, well, his older brother is very smart. You know, he's doing well in school, but he's kind of just going to be a blue collar worker. He's going to have to fight for everything he earns. And if he can just basically graduate, I'd be okay with that. But isn't that really your responsibility as his teacher? So I went and I told him, you know, I spoke with your mom. I see you're failing these classes. And she really is not convinced that you're going to be very successful in school. But I'd really like to help you out. Do you know what your reading score is? And he said, no. I said, well, you're reading like a senior in high school. You can do anything you want. And I just saw a change come over him. And I saw a lot more effort, you know. And I think all of us on his team saw a lot more effort from his classes. It was one of those times I realized this is why I went into teaching. It's not for the paycheck. It's to see kids be successful in life. And hopefully I was able to play a part in that.
Well, when I first met James, I was a consulting educator, but I was also a mentor teacher specialist in Jordan. And I got to know him because he became a lead mentor in his building. We lose so many in the first 5 years. But at James's school, we don't see that kind of turnaround because he has mentored them and proctored them throughout those 3 years.
I love going in and helping new teachers realize that there are certain techniques they can use in the classroom for classroom management. I teach middle school, so it's a lot of management, a lot of behavior management, discipline, things like that. But there's also just kind of an innate sense of how to connect with the students.
When I was trying to decide who to nominate, his name just kept popping into my head. Every single time I was trying to think of maybe someone else, or no one else came up, just James.
It's amazing. It's very humbling, and I feel like I don't deserve it, that I'm going to be exposed as a phony or something like that. I see myself as that kid on the back row, you know, causing problems, making jokes, and I just needed a teacher to reach out to me and show me that I can do anything.